The good news for many happy CX-5 owners in Mazda Australia is that a replacement for the well-liked CX-5 has been officially confirmed. The bad news is that there aren't many specifics about the new model's shape or nomenclature, and Mazda HQ may decide to change it. With the CX-5 accounting for more than 23% of the brand's sales in 2023, this is a huge issue for the local business. In terms of sales, it ranked third among mid-size SUVs, trailing only the Mitsubishi Outlander and Toyota RAV4. Even though Mazda is attempting to conceal information, there is a lot that we do know about this important model. A significant obstacle facing the CX-5 is securing a spot in the ever-evolving Mazda lineup. In Australia, Mazda is leading the way in adopting its successful semi-premium approach, introducing its large product family of energetic premium-positioned vehicles. The CX-80 and CX-90 have already taken the place of the CX-8 and CX-9, and the CX-70 is expected to follow soon. Along with this shift, the Touro mid-size CX-60 has arrived and will cross over with the CX-5 in the existing lineup. There is also the somewhat smaller but more durable CX-50 available in China and the USA, which led to rumors that the CX-5 will just be phased out. That is definitely untrue, though, as Mazda has confirmed that the CX-5 will be replaced, but they haven't stated in what capacity. The new CX-5 is anticipated to remain on its present front and all-wheel drive chassis instead of adopting the new, large products, rear-biased all-wheel drive architecture. This means that the vehicle's underpinnings would likely differ. Given the current gap between the pair, this will be the largest difference between the CX-5 and CX-60, and should allow for a sizable pricing differential. The current CX-5 range is below the entry-level CX-60 Evolve, which is priced from $60,550 and begins at $36,590 for a front-wheel drive max model and tops out at $55,100 for the Acura all-wheel drive. Whether or not the new CX-5 will even go by the name CX-5 is arguably the most important unknown. Vinesh Bindi, managing director of Mazda Australia, stated in June of last year that it was unclear how long the nameplate would be used worldwide.